Hello internet people. So you're wondering how to do a technical SEO audit. Well, in this video, I'll show you three SEO tools that will specify what to improve on your site for better SEO. And two of these tools are directly from Google, and they are totally free. Ka-ching. Each tool will reveal different SEO issues, so make sure to use all of them in combination.
Enough talk.
Tips with Punch.
All right, let's start with the tool that is built right into your Google Chrome's browser. It's called Chrome Lighthouse. It's basically like Google's SEO checker. And it's a great place to start your audit and monitor your website's progress. So just open up your Google Chrome browser.
So to use Chrome's Lighthouse, it's pretty simple. You just go to your website in Chrome and right-click anywhere and then click on Inspect. Then this dev tools will open up, and here you have to go and click on this arrow and you'll see Lighthouse. And here you can select which kind of report you want to see. And I'm just going to uncheck the progressive web app for now, but the rest I'm going to keep. And then click on generate report. For about 30 seconds or a minute, it's going to run its report.
So you can take a nap like this guy.
And there you go. Now it shows you the performance. So here you'll see you have the performance. So this is how fast the page loads. For me right now, it doesn't look good because I've been playing around with some settings and it's not working that well right now. And if I scroll down, there's other all kinds of reports like accessibility, best practices, and then you have your SEO. And here is where you can actually start looking into this. So for example, here it says that the links do not have descriptive text. Now in some cases I can't really do anything about it because this is probably somewhere in my menu or something like that, so it's not always so accurate, but this gives you some indication if you're missing something. And here, for example, it's telling me that one of my images is missing an alt tag, which is quite important with images. And then you can also see here you have past audits. So this just means that this is the good things with this page. Now, Lighthouse works page by page, so it's not that very extensive in that sense.
Disappointed!
Hey, if you liked the video so far, please consider hitting the like button. That will help me a lot. Thanks. Let's move on to the second tool, which is Ubersuggest. This tool can do so much more than just SEO audit, but I'll explore the other features in another video, which you can find in the video card somewhere here above. But for the technical audit, just head to Google and search for Ubersuggest.
And you should land on a page like this. And what I encourage you to do is just sign in with Google. So sign up for this service because you're gonna get more with it. It's completely free. So just sign up. And what you do then is you can run reports for your domain. So here on the left, if you go to SEO Analyzer and then you type in your domain name and then search. And you can see now it started to crawl my website and it'll take about 10 minutes on average. So I'll just wait for that and then I'll show you the results.
We can't make it quick because my horse is getting tired.
And once it's done, you can see you have a dashboard with all kinds of numbers. So for example, you have the scores here, the high level scores. For me, on-page SEO score was 82, which is great. And then here's the important parts that are really interesting. You have the health check, and you can see that I have 10 critical errors and 21 warnings. And then you can just scroll down and see more information about the site speed. And then you have the actual issues. So for example, if I want to see all issues, I'm going to click on this button and it will expand all the issues. So here at the top, six of my pages have low word count, but to be honest, these are category pages, so I'm not too concerned. They're not something I want people to land on. So this is a way to check everything. So you need to just check if everything is all right and if you think you should act on it. So check the critical errors, the warnings, and then you can also see the recommendations. this is a great free tool that you can use to just have an SEO audit over your site and see if anything major comes out of it.
And find out why Google is avoiding you like this.
Why are you running? Why are you running?
My name is Robert and I'm your website guy. And if you're looking to learn more about how to improve your website, get more traffic and other website related stuff, make sure to punch that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any of the new videos. And the third tool I'm going to cover is Google Search Console, a super useful tool provided by Google. If you don't have access to Search Console yet, then check out the video that appears here above. I have a step-by-step guide on how to sign up for this tool and verify that you actually own the website. And that way you just verify with Google. But if you already have Search Console, just go to the dashboard and we'll start from there.
And I promise you, the video will make more sense than this guy's instructions.
I'm climbing the steps to reach my goals.
What? I can't understand anything.
The time will come for you to know.
So just go to Google and search for Search Console. And it's usually the first option. You see in the URL, it's search.google.com. And here, if you just click on start now, you'll end up on this Google Search Console dashboard. And I actually like to start on here. Not only does it show you how many people comes to the site through Google searches, for example, here I have roughly 300 people clicking on my website through Google. And then this is what you want to look at, is the coverage. So you can first of all check this one. So let's go and see. It's also here on the left. It'll give you errors here if Google detects any issues with your site. So for example, in my case, I have this. Some of my pages are marked as no index. In this case, actually, it is on purpose. So if you click on it, it'll take you and shows you which URLs. So I don't want Google to index these pages and show in the search results. That's fine. So if you go back, you can see that some time ago I had a server error. So that means, I don't know, something was wrong with one page, I guess. But right now it's okay. And you might have more or less of these, but here you can see all kinds of stuff. So you have also warnings and all the pages that are valid. And also pages that are excluded. So you could go through this list and see, hey, why is my page on this one? So for example, this is an attachment, so it's not indexed by Google, which is totally fine. And another great tool here inside of Google Search Console is you should check your Core Web Vitals. So you see if you have any poor URLs. So in my case, you see a few days ago it spiked pretty much. All my URLs are now bad. Let's take a look. You can see that there's some loading issues and you should fix this because speed and Core Web Vitals is now a ranking factor. There's like hundreds of them. And same thing, you should check mobile usability. So you should have a mobile friendly website and that way your users can see it on the site and Google also shows your website on searches on mobile. The Google Search Console is a great tool to check that everything is in order and that Google is indexing your pages correctly.
Now, Search Console has many more useful features that you should know about because they help you with SEO in general. I have a video that goes through all the key features, you can see it somewhere here, and how I use them to improve my website's ranking on Google. And here's another video that YouTube thinks you will like. Awesome.